بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وحبيب رب العالمين. There are a lot of people nowadays who say and believe that Allah is everywhere. This statement, it's a corrupt statement. It's not something that was mentioned in the Quran, and it's not something that was mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rather, what's in the Quran and what's in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is what completely is against this statement. Allah mentioned in the Quran, "Laysa kamithlihi shay," which means that Allah is nothing like the creation. So look at the things that Allah created. Look at the things that are actually creation. Among the things that are creations are places, isn't it? A place is a creation, wherever that is, in the street, in the park, in your living room, in the bedroom, on the stairs. All of these things are places, right? And Allah Ta'ala mentioned that He is nothing like the creation. Allah mentioned in the Quran, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. This is in Surah Ash-Shura, Surah 42, Ayah 11. Allah mentioned that He is absolutely nothing like the creation. And places are part of the creation. So Allah, He would not be in a place. He is not in a place. And that makes sense, doesn't it? Because Al-Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he conveyed Al-Islam to the people, and it's something that does not go against sound reasoning. It does not go against the sound mind, against intellectual reasoning. So Allah Ta'ala exists, and He is not in a place. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said in a hadith narrated by Al-Bukhari, كَانَ اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ غَيْرُهُ, which means Allah existed. And this hadith is sahih. It's a strong hadith. It's in Sahih Al-Bukhari. He said, كَانَ اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ غَيْرُهُ. Allah existed and nothing else existed. So, and we can't even imagine this, because when we imagine things, what do we imagine? We imagine it being dark, or it being light, or we imagine, everything we can imagine is creation. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah existed and nothing else existed. So there was no darkness, there was no light, there were no places, there were no emotions, there were no languages, there were no textures, rough and smooth, there were no temperatures, hot and cold. Allah existed and nothing else existed. So Allah existed and there were no places. Which means what? Allah existed without a place, right? And then the scholars of Ahl al-Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the Muslims, they said, Subhana alladhi yughayyir wa la yataghayyar. Which means, look, it means that Allah Ta'ala is free of being like the creation, and He, Allah, changes the creation, but He Himself does not change. So we already said and we agreed that Allah existed without a place. Then after creating the creation, after creating places, He does not change. It doesn't mean that He was without a place and then after creating places, He went into a place. No, because that would mean He changed. Does that make sense? And we change. And you can use that first rule that was mentioned in the Quran, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ, Allah is not like the creation. You can use that rule here because we change and Allah is not like us, so Allah doesn't change. Allah has always existed and has always existed without a place and will always exist without a place. So it's not correct to say that Allah is everywhere. Likewise, it's not correct to say Allah is in the sky. This is actually the belief of the Jews. The Jews believe this, that Allah is in the sky. Likewise, the Christians. And we are Muslims. Also, these people that call themselves, we refer to them as Wahhabiyya. They believe that Allah is in the sky. Anybody who believes that Allah is everywhere, physically everywhere, here and there and up and down, and this person is not a Muslim. This person is not considered to be believing in what Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam brought to the people, which is al-Islam. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammadir Rasulillah, wallahu ta'ala a'lamu wa ahkam.